May. After French, Jenek is Czech. What about you? Because it's always interesting for us to know where people come from because of miles and kilometers, pounds and kilos, Fahrenheit and centigrade, etc. Do we have any British neighbors? Goodbye, happiness. Hello, loneliness. We love you. Now, across the Great Pond, any Canadians? I guess a vast majority of US Americans? Or not? Yeah. Okay, right. But me. Quite a few from down under, Australians here, New Zealanders, any other countries. Sometimes people come from Israel or South Africa or whatever. So, a few British people, our cousins, and US Americans. Thank you. I remind you of fastening your seat belt. Now, we don't need a campaign here, like click it or ticket. Now, we're here in Mannheim. As you know, we aren't far from France. We see more about Germany altogether on the way. Mannheim is a, for us, rather important town, about 300,000 inhabitants. It's an industrial town, many services, many banks, many insurances, and it's the shopping mall of the region. Two important industrial plants, Daimler-Benz, produces here buses and engines for big trucks, and John Deere Europe. You know those big green and yellow tractors?
Yes.
Most of those produced in Europe are produced here. 280 a day here. Engines come from France, the cabins come from not far from here. John Deere overtook in the late 50s an old German tractor company called Lanz that had developed a fabulous, very simple tractor in the 1920s called the Bulldog that could work with any sort of gas. Could have worked with butter, I guess. Anyway, you know how tractors are important in life, don't you? You do. You know that farmer who sent an advert to a local newspaper looking for a wife with a tractor. Please send a picture of the tractor. So John Deere is just ahead of us, across the traffic lights. You might have seen we have seen a few cabins. Perhaps the tractor that actually is most more harvesters, combined harvesters, etc. As for Daimler Benz, the first vehicle you sort of can call a car was invented here in 1886 by Charles Benz Carl, German Carl Benz. It was a very small vehicle with a very small engine with one leather brake on one rear wheel, somehow a car. It seemed that Benz wasn't sure there could be a future for those small horseless vehicles and roads. But his wife, Bertha Benz, thought there might be something to do with that small thing. And one morning, very early, she pushed the third prototype out of the workshop with her two young sons, and she left Mannheim to go visit her parents, who lived at over 100 kilometers, over 65 miles, to the south of Mannheim. It was the adventure, the first car trip ever. The first car trip ever done by a woman. You see in Heidelberg an old stone bridge, that bridge, the first bridge that ever saw a car somehow. Imagine people seeing that small noisy things, you know, not pulled by horses in the street of Heidelberg. And just out of Heidelberg, she ran out of petrol in a small town called Nussloch. And the petrol used by that small thing was a stain remover that you could buy in a pharmacy. She went to the local pharmacy, could get 2.5 liters, so hardly more than half a gallon. And that pharmacy has had a sign for many, many years, first gas station in the world. Anyway, in one day she'd done, Missy Pence had done 104 kilometers. So the first car trip ever. And she drove back 2 days later. So I guess you'd be interested, just type Bertha, B-E-R-T-H-A, Bertha, the daughter of one of his clients. A Mr. Jelinek, who imported racing cars, Daimler racing cars, on the French Riviera in 1900, was so successful that he could decide that he wanted that the cars be named after his own daughter, Mercedes. The only case I've heard of a client who decides of a name of a product. Now, I guess Mercedes, the most famous car name in the world, you know, remember Janis Joplin? I came back by the Mercedes-Benz. All the German cars are produced here in the south, in the 2000 states. A BMW and Porsche, and Audi in Bavaria, and Mercedes-Benz and Porsche here in this state called the Baden-Württemberg. You know, the whole world is full of German cars. It's a very important export product for Germany. So important that the car lobby in Germany is incredibly strong, so strong that Germany is the only country in the world without a general speed limit on all motorways. Even if there's very strong creed feeling in Germany, like in this state, the Prime Minister, a member of the Green Party, even said the first German politician who speaks of limiting speed on all motorways is dead. Now, I've mentioned the name of the state we're in. I guess you know that Germany officially is the Federal Republic of Germany, divided into 16 states. And if you want to, you can have a look at my maps. I'll let them go through if you want to. If you're not interested, just pat them along. With on one side the map of Europe. And the first thing that's right, when you look at the map of Europe, is that we are patchwork of small, very small, or extremely small countries. It's a private is a private technological university with about not quite 2,000 students. They pay, depending on which year, but more or less around 700 euros a month. We have two American universities, a few institutes, and the university that, well, it's a high school that trains primary school teachers. Now here, one student out of five is a medical student. Extremely important for Heidelberg, just like one out of five is a foreigner. This is the highest rate of foreign students in a German university, along with Munich. And those young people are very happy to study here. It's a nice place, and their parents are especially happy because of the tuition fees that are 0.0 euro a semester for German and for foreign students. Now, we belong to those cultures, societies, that consider it a duty providing free tuition to young people and even to foreigners. Because somehow, if you study in a university in a foreign country,
that this a lot.
University Square, and then up to the castle.
Chris Stolen bicycles.